So let's start. So why CSAT is troubling everyone now? The very first reason for that is CSAT has been made qualifying, hence UPSC is increasing its difficulty level every year. Okay. More focus on reading comprehension, which is time consuming with generic or vague options, right? They are asking what is the summary of this passage, what is the message of this passage, what does this passage want to convey, what is the central theme, right? And all of those four options are pretty vague and very generic. Let's not call it vague, they were very generic. I got 95 in GS but failed in CSAT. Yes sir, very close options too. Yes, exactly. That's the tricky part, na? Because this examination is not about selecting you. UPSC wants to reject everyone that is appearing. The people who get selected, they get selected on their own, okay? UPSC wants to reject everyone. Out of lakhs of people who appear, let's say 50,000 were serious. 30 from Old Rajendranagar, 20 from Mukherjee Nagar, maybe more from Mukherjee Nagar. Okay, then what happens is, out of those 50,000-60,000 who were serious even a bit, rest are like they are appearing just for the sake of appearing. The real people who studied for UPSC civil services examination is close to that only. Out of those, only 10 to 15,000 will get through, rest got rejected. Out of those, close to 2,000, 2,500, close to that, based upon the vacancies that UPSC releases every year, they will get through. Out of those, close to 700 or 800 will get through. Okay, so 60,000 and 700. Examination is about rejection. Okay, so if you get rejected, feel happy that UPSC is successful in its mission. Next year, I am going to beat UPSC. Okay, so there are aspirants with varied background like engineering, humanities, Hindi medium, etc., who focus less on reading and more on math section. Apart from maths, there are sections like data sufficiency, general mental ability, data interpretation, etc., which are not exactly mathematics. Okay, so if you are from humanities background and if you think that maths is your enemy since birth, then still you can clear CSAT, because there are other portions which should not be ideally called maths. There are terms like general mental ability. Okay, there's nothing that I am going to teach you here. There's nothing new. You already know everything. You need to practice and be clear with that, right? Less practice by most of the aspirants. The biggest problem that everyone faces, everybody wants to read. Kaun sa magazine aata hai wo? 365. Okay, everybody wants to read that. I want to focus only on paper 1, because paper 1, if I clear cutoff in paper 1, then only I will get through. But we forget that we need to get 66 marks in CSAT as well. Okay. So this is the single biggest problem, less practice by most of the aspirants. So there are some common myths that I want to discuss with you. Is there anyone from Hindi medium? Chalo, then it's fine. So these are the common myths. That's all right. The guy mentioned the name, but let's not, you know, take the names as such. Okay. So there are some common myths. The very first one is Hindi medium students need to struggle for CSAT due to English. Wrong. If you don't know English, no issues. Skip those 26 questions, right? There are still 54 more questions to deal with. Okay. Engineers are having a cakewalk in CSAT. Again, a myth. Everyone is struggling. Okay, everyone is struggling. There are many friends of mine, and this is happening since 2017 at least. A friend of mine, he used to work with some institute. He scored 140 plus in paper 1, but could not score 65 in CSAT. And the same is happening everywhere. It's not that people in Rajendranagar are having the problem. Mukherjee Nagar and all over India as well. Everyone is scared about CSAT due to some reason or the other, but that should not be the case ideally. Humanities people find CSAT tough nut to crack due to mathematics, their arch enemy. It's all right. Maths is very easy these days. It's the reading comprehension that's killing me. It's also not the same. Because see what happens is there's a term in economics called spreading or hedging your risk. Okay. Spread means if you have 100 rupees and you spend all of those 100 rupees in one particular thing. Okay. You buy gold. There's no surety, like in the very long run, gold is going to increase in price, but in the short run, it might go down. Last year it happened, gold went from 45,000 to 58,000 and it's again now hovering at around 50,000. Okay. Yes, don't put all eggs in one basket. So if you invest 20 in land, 20 in gold, 20 in shares, 20 in bonds, 20 in something else, so even if one is falling short, the profit from other will make that money of 100 rupees grow into something much more like 105, 110. Okay. And there's a chance that one asset might go down, like let's say equity turn to zero. Still, you won't lose all your money. Right. So this is very aptly put. Don't put all eggs in one basket. Very true. Nice. So when there are various sections in CSAT, if you practice all of them, right? If you practice all of them, if you spot one easy question from one section, then you will do it automatically. You will go out, you will find that question and you will do it. Okay. But if you skip any section, like you skip, let's say data sufficiency. If you see questions from, or if you see some question which you have not seen till date because you skipped one section, then even if like it is very easy, it won't make sense. You can go and check in 2000, I guess 12 or 13, one data interpretation question was asked, one pie chart was made, okay, and some comparison had to be made out of those two. So before starting, I simply just tried to add all of those percentages. So in one pie chart, the percentage was going to 105. That's not possible. Okay, so that's how I got my answer. I did not have to go through mathematics and all of those things, right? So let's discuss this part properly. When UPSC wants to reject you, even if you are qualified, even if you have studied properly in your graduation, school, whatsoever, like there are very few people who, you know, just sail through everything. Topper in 10, topper in 12, topper in college, topper in UPSC. Okay, but like there are other mango people who have to struggle a lot, and we need to know this thing first. There were 26 reading comprehensions this year, with most of them having only one question. Almost every question had just every passage had one question only. Okay. In the starting, there are 4 RCs alternating with other sections, which later tapers down to just 2 RC. Did you notice this thing? In the starting, they want you to get tangled in the web of reading comprehension, reading, getting your answers wrong because you have to go fast. Okay. And towards the end, they were just like 2 RC, then another section, then 2 RC, then other questions, and everything was very easy. Okay. UPSC wants to find some qualities in the candidate, some very inherent qualities. So whatever you do with regards to UPSC, your preparation, prelims, mains, interview, you always need to keep one thing in your mind, that UPSC has got the country's best psychologists and psychoanalysts. Okay. So in their test, they are going to put some things which will slow you down or hinder your progress or whatsoever, just to see what sort of a person you are, how mentally well prepared you are to face difficulties. If you can't face CSAT, how can you face a mob of 10,000 people standing in front of your office? If you are SP of some city and there's a mob of 10,000 people over there, police will act as per your orders and whatever orders you got from your seniors, DM, minister, whatsoever. Okay. If there's a mob of 10,000 who are pretty angry over some issue and they want to torch the whole station down, would you run away? Would you go and hide? Would you lead your team and don't care for your life? Okay. So it starts from very, very small things. So Then alternating RC with quite difficult looking yet manageable questions. So there were, these are the questions, some of the questions that I picked. There were 1, 2, 3, 4 RC, then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then again 4 RC, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and likewise. In the starting there were 4 RCs, then some questions, then 4 RCs, then some questions. Okay. So this is the question that I just discussed. You open paper, in you find 4 RCs. Okay, they are lengthy RCs. You try to solve them. You might get them correct, you might get them incorrect, but you have to rush because you can't be stuck there for 15-20 minutes. Okay. Now you land over here, and what happens? You find a question which you can't handle or you don't want to handle. Okay. So you panic. Now the game is set. The stage is set by UPSC for you, and UPSC will play with you from here onwards. See, there are some scenarios which you can't foretell, okay, what's going to happen, but you can be cool and you can try to solve at least. Why? Because once you overcome this question or you totally ignore it, cross it, there are so many easy questions to solve. There are so many easy questions to solve. Okay, so let's see, which one do you want to solve? Let's do this one. I really love these types of questions, the 10th one. Do you want any of the questions to get solved? Do we have question number 36? Consider all 3-digit numbers without repetition of digits obtained using 3 non. Question number 36. A play with a ball and bounce. Which set you are referring to? Because in my set, question number 36 is different. Haha. In the chat they mentioned set C. Set C ka 36 question kaun sa sakta hai? Ball and bounce. This one, question 49. Two statements and four conclusions. You have to take the statement to be true even if they seem to be at variance from the commonly known fact. Read all conclusions and then decide which of the given conclusion logically follows from the statement disregarding the commonly known facts. Is it the same one? A play with a ball and bounce. Joseph, defense.
Yeah, 16 number.
Okay. A boy plays with a ball and he drops it from a height of 1.5 meters. Every time the ball hits the ground, it bounces back to attain a height 4/5 of the previous height. The ball does not bounce further if the previous height is less than 50 centimeters. What is the number of times the ball hits the ground before the ball stops bouncing? Okay. There can be two ways. Yeah, fine. I got it. It is question number 16 in my set. So there are two methods of solving it. Okay. Because they have mentioned numbers till 7. So either you can go for the iteration and try to solve it, whether it goes on like that or not, or you can use another method. Kya kya hai isme 1.5, 4/5, 50 centimeter. So the question is trying to say that a ball is dropped from a height of 1.5 meters and it bounces back to 4/5 of the height. यहाँ से bounce इसको drop किया था, ये यहाँ तक वापस आएगा. Again, when it will go down and bounce back, it will come up to a certain height. Okay. सो इट विल स्टॉप, हाँ इट विल स्टॉप बाउंसिंग व्हेन द लास्ट हाइट वाज 50 सेंटीमीटर. अगर 50 सेंटीमीटर तक आया तो अब उसके बाद जो और ज़्यादा बाउंस नहीं होना है इसमें. 50 सेंटीमीटर, ओके. तो द क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स दिस प्रोसेस इज गोइंग टू रिपीट. ओके, सो इधर यू कैन ट्राई टू कैलकुलेट दैट यू नो इतना आया, फिर इतना गया, फिर इतना आया, फिर इतना गया, या फिर आप डायरेक्टली इसको सॉल्व भी कर सकते हो. दोनों तरीकों से करें. ओके, सो पहले आया, इसको ले लो 150 सेंटीमीटर. सो फर्स्ट टाइम जब बाउंस करेगा तो आएगा 120 सेंटीमीटर. सेकेंड टाइम बाउंस करेगा तो आएगा 96. थर्ड टाइम बाउंस करेगा तो कितना आएगा? 4th year आप जाओगे तो कैसे कहाँ तक जाएगा? 76.8 into 4/5 चौथी बार बाउंस करके आया. फर्स्ट बाउंस, सेकंड बाउंस, थर्ड बाउंस, फोर्थ बाउंस, नाउ फिफ्थ वन. 61.4 इनटू 4/5 इज इक्वल टू 50 से कम हो गया हाइट इसका. नाउ इट वोंट बाउंस एनी फर्दर. सो 5 इज द मैक्सिमम नंबर बाय विच इट इज गोइंग टू बाउंस. ओके, अनदर मेथड इज इसको सॉल्व करने का ये हो सकता है. 150 इंटू 4/5 टू द पावर n करके व्हेन वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस बेसिकली दिस वैल्यू ऑफ n. ओके, द वैल्यू ऑफ n विल गिव दस गिव अस दिस नंबर. It has to be less than 50. So hit and trial वाली चीज़ है. वैसे तो आप ऐसे भी कर सकते हो इसको कि 4/5 would be 80%. एनीवेज इसमें भी वही करना पड़ सकता है. सो लाइक दिस इज सम मैथमेटिक्स विच यू माइट फाइंड टीडियस टू डू, बट आई गेस दिस मेथड सॉल्व्स इट. इस तरीके से आप जाओगे तो भी ठीक है, बट दिस इज अ बेटर मेथड टू डू. वीडियो इज नॉट स्मूथ. ओके, सो दिस मेथड इज फाइन विथ यू? दैट्स हाउ वी आर द वे वी सॉल्व इट. इज इट ऑल राइट? So One more question that I want to discuss with you is just to give you an idea ki how to tackle these questions. Question number 10, a statement followed by conclusion 1 and conclusion 2 is given below. You have to take the statement to be true. ठीक है, UPSC भी लिखने लगा है. स्टेटमेंट इज सम रेडियोज आर मोबाइल्स, ऑल मोबाइल्स आर कंप्यूटर्स, सम कंप्यूटर्स आर वॉचेस. हाउ विल यू डू दिस? Tenth question. Someone is saying the answer is 6. How can the answer be 6? When it was dropped the very first time, on the very first bounce, it will come to height of 120. This is first bounce, this is second bounce, this is third bounce, fourth bounce, fifth bounce. On the fifth bounce, the height to which it went to was 49.3 centimeter. And the question specifically says that if the previous height was 50 centimeter, it won't bounce any further. So how can it go for sixth bounce? The answer is 5. It's not 6. Yeah, so tell me, how will you try to solve such questions or how to approach such questions? Batao.
Sir, uska answer confirm ho.
Kiska? Fifth wale ka. Aapka method aa gaya theek se? 7 aa raha hai. चलो ठीक है, 7 मान लेते हैं. मुझे बता देना उसके बाद में फिर. ठीक है, 10th वाला बताओ. मैडम द क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट सी सेट नॉट जी एस, वेदर ग्रेविटी विल पुल बैक और नॉट. द क्वेश्चन स्पेसिफिकली सेज द बॉल डज नॉट बाउंस फर्दर द प्रीवियस हाइट इज लेस देन 50 सेंटीमीटर. एनीवेज ये वाला बताइए. सम रेडियोज आर मोबाइल्स, ऑल मोबाइल्स आर कंप्यूटर्स, सम कंप्यूटर्स आर वॉचेस. कैसे सॉल्व किया आपने? ये विन डायग्राम बनाना पड़ेगा. और सबसे पहली बात तो ये है कि अगर अब तो वह कैसे यूपीएससी ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछ नहीं रहा है, बट इफ देर इज एनी ऑप्शन विच कुड बी अराइव्ड फ्रॉम वन और टू स्टेटमेंट्स दैट इज आउटराइटली रॉन्ग, वी नीड ऑल थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स टू कम अप टू सर्टेन कंक्लूजन. सो वेन डायग्राम से ही सॉल्व होगा ये. एक मिनट जरा स्टेटमेंट बताने यार. मोबाइल्स आर सम रेडियोज आर मोबाइल्स. सम रेडियोज आर मोबाइल्स. ठीक है, ऑल मोबाइल्स आर कंप्यूटर्स, सम कंप्यूटर्स आर वॉचेस. ऑल मोबाइल्स आर कंप्यूटर्स. और क्या था? सम कंप्यूटर्स आर वॉचेस. तो it could be this, it could be this, it could be this. Even further, अगर यहाँ तक भी हम ला सकते हैं तो भी काम चल जाएगा. W1, W2, W3, ठीक है. Some radios are mobiles, all mobiles are computers, some computers are watches. ठीक है. फ़ोन है किसी के पास? ज़रा स्नैपशॉट ले लो इसका, जो है मतलब फोटो ले लो बार बार, वरना ऑल्टरनेट करना पड़ रहा है. टू मोबाइल, हाउ डू यू नो वॉचेस शुड नॉट टच मोबाइल? इज इट मैंशन? दिस इज द ट्रिक यार, दिस इज द ट्रिक. इफ इट इज नॉट मैंशन देन यू हैव टू अज्यूम दिस इज हाउ वेन डायग्राम आर मेड. ओके, सो क्या कंक्लूजन है पहला? क्या कंक्लूजन था पहला वाला? सर्टेनली सम रेडियोज आर वॉचेस, सम रेडियोज आर वॉचेस. ओके, सर्टेनली सम रेडियोज आर वॉचेस. देखो ये अगला जो है वो यहां तक आ सकता है, W4. ठीक है, आपको वेन डायग्राम कैसे ड्रॉ किया समझ में आया आपको? ठीक है, तो ज़रूरी नहीं है कि ट्रू हो, बिकॉज W1, W2, W3 भी तो है ना. सर्टेनली यूज़ किया है, वो बोलता ना मे बी, तो सही हो सकता था, बट बोला सर्टेनली. आपको कैसे पता है W4? जब तक मैं W4 ड्रॉ नहीं किया था, मैं W1 ड्रॉ करके रुक जाता तो दीज वॉचेस कुड नॉट बी रेडियोज. हाँ, ये सारे पॉसिबिलिटी हैं. जब उसने सर्टेनिटी बोल दिया ना कि सर्टेनली ऐसा है, तब आप इसीलिए इतने सारे वेन डायग्राम आप ड्रॉ करके आप इसको देखते हो, सो दैट यू कैन सी फॉर श्योर कि किसी की प्रोबेबिलिटी है, किसी की प्रोबेबिलिटी नहीं है. ठीक है, तो दिस इज नॉट करेक्ट. सर्टेनली सम मोबाइल्स आर वॉचेस. ये मोबाइल हैं, ये वॉचेस हैं. ठीक है, W5 यहाँ हो सकता है. ठीक है, यहाँ कहीं हो सकता है, तो इसलिए ये भी गलत है. नीदर ऑफ देम, बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट से फॉर श्योर सर्टेनली वर्ड होने के कारण. एग्जैक्टली. देन लेट्स सॉल्व सम मोर. Is there any question which you want to discuss?
ऐसे क्वेश्चन जनरली टफ नहीं होते हैं, पढ़ते नहीं कई बार, मतलब मेरे साथ होता है पैनिक हो जाता हूँ.
शांति से देखो, आप पैनिक कर रहे हो, इसका मतलब क्या है? आप सोच रहे हो. ठीक है, सोचना नहीं है बहुत ज़्यादा. इफ यू प्रैक्टिस यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली रिएक्ट. ठीक है, बिकॉज इफ यू नो समथिंग यू विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट. इफ यू डोंट नो समथिंग, वहाँ आप दो घंटे बैठ करके करने का, इट डजेंट मेक एनी सेंस. ठीक है, और कोई क्वेश्चन बताओ अगर लगता है डिस्कस करना चाहिए तो. ये तो बहुत सिंपल सा है, तो कोई कर सकते हो ना, कोई भी आराम से. मैडम ये वाले वैसे वेन डायग्राम से ही आता है, वेन डायग्राम बना के देख लो, उससे क्वेश्चन सॉल्व हो जाते हैं. यहाँ से डिस्कस करना है ये वाला.
ट्वेंटी एट.
यू आर गिवन टू आइडेंटिकल सीक्वेंसेस इन टू रोज. What is the entry in the place of C for the sequence 2? ठीक है, बताओ आप ये करना है कि ये वाला करना है? ये तो बहुत बहुत ईजी है, यही वाला कर लेते हैं अपन. इसका भी फोटो ले लोगे तो ठीक रहेगा. ले लिया आपने? क्या सीक्वेंस है बताइए. क्या सीक्वेंस था? फोटो ही ले लो ना, बहुत बहुत इजी रहेगा। लास्ट वाले फिर वो है ना डेसिमल में, आप लिख लो सही रहेगा। फोटो ले लिया? हाँ बताइए। हाँ सीक्वेंस वन
8 4 6
15
32.5
236.25 नीचे क्या है? 5
A
B C D E। ठीक है, तो उसने बोला है ये पता करने के लिए, राइट? सी बोला है ना। तो देखो यार, इसके अंदर सिंपल सा ये है कि वी नीड टू एस्टैब्लिश सम पैटर्न ओवर हियर। द सेम पैटर्न वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 5 बिकॉज पहला हमको नंबर दिया गया है, तो उससे हमको ये सारे मिल जाएंगे। ठीक है, सो बिकॉज यहाँ पे 0.5 0.25 है, सो एक काम करते हैं, इन सभी को 4 से मल्टीप्लाई कर देते हैं, डेसिमल हटा ही देते हैं अपन। ठीक है, फिफ्टी टू था ना ये?
फिफ्टी
टू। तो ठीक है ना, ये हमको अब लेकर के चलना है। यहाँ पर नीचे अभी के लिए 20 कर देते हैं, बाद में फिर जो है उसको कम कर लेंगे। चलो ठीक है, देखते हैं अभी फिर। सो कैन यू थिंक ऑफ एनी पैटर्न इमर्जिंग आउट ओवर हियर? चलो डिफरेंस देख लेते हैं इनके बीच का। पावर कैसे हो गया? लास्ट 5 हो गया, एक नंबर मिस हो गया था। अभी भी कुछ पैटर्न नहीं दिख रहा ना, ये वो क्वेश्चन है जिसको छोड़ के आगे बढ़ जाना चाहिए, और बहुत सारे इजी सवाल हैं। मैं आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू सॉल्व इट, बिकॉज द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम इज व्हेन यू हैव टू ट्राई टू फाइंड पैटर्न्स ना, कई बार ऐसा होता है कि इसके हो सकता है एक आध लेवल आपको और आगे जाना पड़े, एंड द इशू इज विथ 5 हियर। ठीक है, सो आई विल टेल यू वेरी फनी फैक्ट, अभी बताता हूँ अगले स्लाइड के अंदर। इसमें हम लौट के आते हैं फिर से। ठीक है सर, 60 यू लेफ्ट, यस 60 आई लेफ्ट बाई मिस्टेक। आगे वाले क्वेश्चन काफी इजी हैं। ठीक है, दिस इज व्हाट आई वांटेड टू डिस्कस। CSAT has been made qualifying, hence UPSC is increasing its difficulty level every year. Hence we qualify as well. हम भी कर लेते हैं ना, क्या दिक्कत है? One third mark is 66.66, net 26.66 or 27 correct attempts. All we need is 27 correct questions. Net. Net समझते हो ना? सही है. So when you have to attempt only 27 questions correctly and get through, then why to get tangled in the web which UPSC wants to play game with you, right? So for everybody who wants to discuss question, I can discuss full paper with you, no issues with that. Already lots of people have done that. I wanted to come to this part first. If you want, we can discuss that later as well. Theek hai? So when you need 27 correct attempts, if you go at home, sit at peace and try to look for questions, you will easily find 30 questions which you can attempt without any issue, right? If you want to be safe, make it 35, 40, whatsoever. But 30 questions are very easy. The only issue is to solve those or to find those 27 questions in those 2 hours. That is the biggest problem. More focus on reading comprehension. This is the first slide which I discussed, okay? So that's why more focus on reading comprehension, which is time consuming with generic or vague options. So we solve other sections first and come back to RC later. Solving RC in hurry is like taking a wild guess with eyes closed. Okay. Whenever I used to write, what I would do is I will just keep skipping this RC portion and will focus on others only. Okay. Because some topics are very easy. Data sufficiency, data interpretation, general mental ability. 4 figures have been drawn, like, or 3 are drawn, and what should be the 4th one? Some rotation is there, some triangle is there, some square is there, some circle is there. Such questions are pretty easy. They should be solved first. You won't take more than 5 to 10 seconds when you are doing those. Okay. The real problem is with RC. We need to practice everything. Sir? इसको शेयर कर सकते हैं, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है इसको. दो मिनट में कर दो. ओके सर. ओके सर. सो आई विल प्रैक्टिस एवरीथिंग बिकॉज स्पीड इज द की, बट आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द नॉन आरसी पोर्शन in first 40 or 45 minutes. Whatever I can, I would solve. What I could not, or it's time taking, I would simply leave it, because there are some questions which are really tricky. One of those classic questions is establishing the relationship thing. Okay. Relationship wale jo hote hain, haan. There are 5 people. There is 1 mother, there is 1 sister, there is 1 brother. Okay. So those questions, they take time. They are very tricky questions. This is the trick, to skip those sections, move to things which you can easily manage, because it's now not counting while you are qualifying. Okay. You only need to score 27 correct attempts. Why to waste time on those questions, right? There are some questions which will take time. Okay, once it happened with me, a friend of mine, he was in a very bad condition because he was scoring the same person, 150 plus, okay, and he could not be sure whether these 5 questions, those relationship ones, whether they are correct or not. In the hall, I tried for 10 minutes, then I was having headache, so I closed the paper and slept there only. He asked me to do that because he was really nervous. He wanted to know whether these 5 questions are correct or not, because that would decide whether he will be qualifying prelims or not. So I just sat over there, and within 1 minute I solved it. Okay. In the hall I was trying for 10 minutes, my head started to pain. I was like, I don't want to do it. I just want to get done with this thing and go home and sleep. Okay. So that's how it happens. Whatever is happening in the examination hall, you need to control it, because once you get back, you can manage it anyhow. Given 4 hours, you can easily solve the paper full. The trick is to do it in 2 hours only, with those RCs which you need to read at least 3 to 4 times. Okay. Last me hi karne chahiye. That's what I'm trying to tell you. See, if RC is going to take 1 hour 20 minutes, or let's say 1 hour RC is going to take, because there are 26 questions, you need to at least read them 4 to 5 times, the difficult ones, to get to the correct answer. Okay, so if you start with RC, okay, you will see that you are left with 54 questions now, which need to be done in 1 hour. In that, you need to find the easy ones, the difficult ones, the ones you should do, the ones you should not do. But if you do the reverse, now you have gone through almost these 54 questions in 40 minutes. You know which ones to do, you know which ones not to do, or to come back later. Okay, and then in the next 1 hour, you are going to do these RC things. So now you are relaxed. The chances of you solving RC properly now are more. Okay. So aspirants with varied background like engineering, humanities, Hindi medium, etc., who focus less on reading and more on math section, not maths exactly. So we learn about and practice all the sections, understanding that some are more important than the other. Every section has questions ranging from moderate to advanced difficulty. You will find such questions in every section. Some would be very easy, some would be very tricky. The basic idea is to eat the breadcrumbs first. Whatever you can easily solve, just do it first. Because the problem is not that people can't score, like get 27 questions correct. The problem is they will get 50 correct and then they will get 20 wrong. This is the biggest problem, right? Ma'am, how many did you get right and wrong in CSAT? Sorry for asking, but I just want to...
16% are correct.
16 are correct?
Yes, sir.
And how many incorrect?
Incorrect, around 17, 18.
So, okay. Every section has questions ranging from moderate to advanced difficulty. We attempt every section, okay, we practice every section, we find the easy ones first and take up others later. Because if you find and do easy ones only, then only you can clear the exam. Okay. And why not catch the easy questions from all the sections first and ensure enough time for tricky questions and RC later. Okay. So what we can, should or must be done. Less practice by most of the aspirants. So practice, practice and more practice. That's it. Nothing else will enable you to clear CSAT. Just practice. To be precise, there's nothing to learn in CSAT. It's a test of what is innate in us. We try to strengthen what you already know. Okay. This is a very famous quote by Swami Vivekananda, that knowledge is the epitome of what all we already know. I don't remember the quote exactly, but this is what he was trying to say. Whatever we read or whatever we are taught, teaching and being taught is a different thing. That is for children. But as adults, we know lots of things on our own. Okay, if I put the same ratio proportion question to you in a very simple manner, you will be able to tell me everything. Okay, the problem comes when you don't know that and it is presented to you in a complex form. Okay. Madam, of humanities background, if I try to teach you probability right now, you will understand. But if you find a question on probability in the hall, maybe you would find it tricky, because वहाँ पे कुछ trick लगेगा या formula लगेगा या कुछ भी. Okay. जैसे अगर मैं आपसे पूछूँ, I have a bag and it has one black ball and one white ball. If I ask you to pick white ball, what is the probability that you will pick the white ball? 1/2 तो maths हो गया ना. कितना probability है? 50-50, right? 50-50 is 1/2. अगर मैं उसमें दो ब्लैक बॉल और डाल दूँ, ना व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी कि आप अगर हाथ डाल के उसमें से बॉल निकालोगे तो वाइट बॉल निकलेगा?
1/4,
25%. ठीक है, इसी को जब और कॉम्प्लेक्स करते चले जाते हैं ना, तो इसी में आप प्रोबेबिलिटी के फिर क्वेश्चंस बनते जाते हैं. आपको पता है ना, मैंने आपको कुछ नया सिखाया तो नहीं ना यहाँ पे. यू ऑलरेडी नो दिस थिंग. दो में से एक निकालो, 50-50 चांस है. ठीक है, यही है कि इट्स लेस अबाउट टीचिंग एंड मोर अबाउट प्रैक्टिसिंग, बिकॉज देर आर थिंग्स वी ऑलरेडी नो.
एग्जैक्टली
एग्जैक्टली. वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू इज यू ऑलरेडी नो एवरीथिंग. ओके. करंट अफेयर्स में हमें पढ़ना पड़ता है बिकॉज हमें नहीं पता वो सारी चीज़ें. बट जनरल मेंटल एबिलिटी जिसको बोलते हैं, ये सिविल सर्विस एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट है. एप्टीट्यूड वी ऑल हैव, कम हो ज़्यादा हो, बहुत प्रैक्टिस हो कम प्रैक्टिस हो, बट एप्टीट्यूड वी ऑल हैव. ओके. द इशू इज ऑफ फियर इनहिबिशन और एटीट्यूड. ये एटीट्यूड है एथिक्स वाला. क्या होता है एथिक्स में एटीट्यूड? सॉरी, नो, दैट इज एप्टीट्यूड. When you look forward to doing something properly or trying to learn something properly, that is your aptitude.
Way of approaching.
Yes, way of approaching. In the sense, your attitude means it's not about way of approaching exactly or something. Even if you don't approach anything, okay. I am just sitting over here and I'm thinking about when I go to Manali. Okay, there will be lots of snow, and it would be very cold, so I should not go. This is my attitude towards Manali. My attitude could also be like, if I go to Manali right now, there would be lots of snow and I love snow. Let's go. Okay. So that is the real meaning behind the word attitude, right? More important things to do like study GS, optional, ethics, essay, etc., etc. Practice makes us fluent. We stop thinking and we start to act. So allocate only one day per week, if not more, and simply practice. Okay, be consistent in your approach. Be very consistent in your approach. Okay, you need to be, you come over here, you study at your room, no issues. Okay, but be consistent. Every Sunday decide that you will sit for 1 to 2 hours and practice questions. Try to cover all the sections that are there. Okay, and practice. Practice will lead you to places which, you know, normally talent won't. प्रैक्टिस करना बहुत ज़रूरी है. यूपीएससी वाई इट इज़ डूइंग सो, रिड्यूस ओवर डिपेंडेंस ऑन वन पेपर, टेस्ट ओवरऑल टेम्परामेंट ऑफ द कैंडिडेट, इट्स एन एग्जाम ऑफ रिजेक्शन. ओके, सो कीप अ बैलेंस अप्रोच. सी सेट इज अ स्किल सेट टेस्ट, इट्स नॉट अ लाइबिलिटी. ओके, इफ यू स्टार्ट टू डू इट, इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड थिंग्स विच यू आर रीडिंग, देन ऑब्वियसली यू विल स्टार्ट, यू विल लाइक टू, you would like to do the CSAT. okay, it's not as if ki humko nahi aata hum nahi karenge. exam clear karna hai, karna padega, baith ke enjoy karne ka, isko liability nahi samajhne ka.